Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you a very common mistake that might happen to you until you get used to how variables are evaluated. Let's start looking at this piece of code. It's a simple percentage. It just divides the sales amount by calculate sales amount for all the product. It produces a percentage, which is the percentage of sales against the grand total. Now, when you start using DAX, we always teach that you need to use variables as much as you can, because variables improve the readability of the code, improve performance. In general, they are a great tool. Therefore, you might be tempted to say, well, you know what? I evaluate sales amount multiple times, I can store that into a variable. So I can write a variable sales amount where I store the result of sales amount. And then I use the same expression in multiple places. So I transform this code into divide sales amount by calculate again sales amount for all the products. Even though this code looks very close to the previous one, as you're going to see, it's wrong. As soon as I hit enter, this produces 100% everywhere. Why that? Because a variable is not evaluated in the filter context where it is used. A variable is evaluated once and forever when it is defined. So, sales amount is evaluated here and its value does not change even though I change the filter context. The value of sales amount here is the same value of sales amount here, same number. And even if I change this to the original measure, this is not going to change. Why that? Because the filter context here is the same filter context which is available here. Therefore, the variable is evaluated here in the same filter context as the numerator, and if I hit enter, the number is still 100%. Therefore, variables are useful. They simplify your code, but they are not the solution all the time. If you want to use variables here, well, then you need to use two variables. In one, you store the sales amount. In another variable, you store the sales amount for all, where you compute the value of sales amount in the filter context where you want that to happen. So we take this code, we put it here, and we write the full expression here, sales amount. And then we divide one variable by the other. So we divide sales amount by sales amount for all. Sales amount for all. So I am using variable, I am following DAX best practices, but each variable is evaluated in the filter context where the number makes sense. And if I hit enter, now I have again nice code and the numbers are right. Enjoy DAX!